Welcome to another According to Anna video. And today, you're gonna watch me attempt to make a body spray with essential oils. I say that you're gonna attempt to watch me because I have never actually done this. About a year and a half ago, Randy and I made the decision to cut out perfume and colognes from our lifestyle. Mostly because perfumes contain a lot of harmful chemicals, like petrochemicals, which is petroleum and other natural gases. So it's like, why do we need that in our on our bodies and getting that in our systems? So that was just our personal decision. And since then, like I said, it's been a year and a half, I've been meaning to get around to making our own body spray from essential oils, which is a lot safer and healthier, and I just haven't gotten around to it. But today, that changes, and you're gonna watch me. There are a slew of different, like, do-it-yourself recipes for like your own perfume and body spray using essential oils. I'm kind of doing a mix match of several recipes and kind of doing my own thing. So again, if you are a rule follower, I would suggest looking up a recipe online, but there are hundreds, so you're in luck. There's plenty to choose from. So here's what I'm going to be using, and if you would like to attempt this at some point as well, this is what you're gonna need. You're going to need a glass spray bottle, and you can pick those up at like a natural grocery store. This came from Earth Fair. But I know Sprouts carries them as well, and definitely Whole Foods. But if you don't have any of those stores in your area, Amazon also sells them. It's a good idea when using essential oils to use glass bottles and not plastic, because there are certain essential oils that would perhaps eat through the plastic bottles, and you don't want that. So glass all the way. You're going to need water, preferably distilled, so that your body spray will last longer. Almond oil. This is optional, but I'm gonna be using this in my body spray. You're going to need vodka. If the thought of even walking into a liquor store to get vodka for a body spray recipe offends you, you can also use witch hazel. I personally am going with the vodka. And of course, the main ingredient, essential oils. As you can see, I may have quite a few to choose from. I have options. I am doing two body sprays. I'm gonna do one more floral spray that will be mine. And then I'm also gonna do like a woodsy man of the woods spray, and that can be Randy's. And if I choose to do that one sometimes too, that's okay. And that one may be good for good old Justin Timberlake. I don't know. Many of the articles that I read suggested finding a base note, a middle note, and a top note when it came to the essential oils. Each of the essential oils will fall under those three categories. If you Google this, you will see the list, and you can work from that if you would like. Apparently, the top note is what you will smell when you first spray the body spray. But it's also gonna fade the quickest. So the other two help balance that out. Looking at it just kind of made my head hurt a little bit. So I just went and found a recipe that someone already put together. So I suggest just finding like a recipe someone already put together. There's a lot of those to choose from too. Like I said, I'm going with more of a romantic floral scent, and I'm also gonna do the woodsy scent. So let me show you the oils I'm going to use. Cute and very like Valentine-y. It's super appropriate. I didn't exactly plan it that way, but hey, I'm rolling with it. So in mine, I'm gonna have orange, lavender, patchouli, cedarwood, lang lang, and bergamot. Bergamot is my absolute favorite. So of course I had to find a recipe that included it. For the woodsy scent, I'm going with Northern Lights Black Spruce, juniper, cedarwood, bergamot, and vetiver. such a fun one to say, which I always feel like I'm saying it incorrectly, and I probably am. Just a note about vetiver. It is a very thick and somewhat sappy oil, so it's going to be harder to get out of the bottle. And for the longest time, I didn't use it because it's like, it's just too slow coming out and it's just super sappy. And then someone told me that it was really helpful to warm it up first. So you can warm it up for a little bit in between your palms like this. Or she suggested, and this is what I do, just sticking it in your bra for about 5 minutes. And that warms up very quick. So this little guy, that's where he's going right now. So while that's warming up, I'm gonna mix mine. I'm not sure why I'm nervous about mixing all this together. Probably just because I've never done it before. We're going to first mix the sweet almond oil. After we open it, it does us no good right now. I'm gonna pass it on to my assistant. Thank you, assistant. We're gonna do 1 tablespoon of the sweet almond oil into our funnel you go. Now we're going to add our essential oils. I'm gonna start with orange. And I'm gonna do about 10 drops of orange. And 11 drops of orange. I'm gonna do 5 or 6 drops of lavender. 6 drops of lavender. I'm gonna do 10 drops of patchouli. This is another sappy one that I forgot how sappy it is. So I should have warmed it up first. But it's gonna come. It's gonna think about it for a minute. I see a drop. We have a drop. Maybe mine won't have patchouli. 1, 2. Aren't you glad for the fast forward feature? And 10. All right. 10 drops of cedarwood. 5 drops of lang lang. Which that's really fun to say too. And last, but most certainly not least, is bergamot. I'm gonna do about 5 or 6 drops of bergamot. Or 7 or 8, it kinda just poured out. Oh, why can't you be more like bergamot? Now we're going to mix our vodka or our witch hazel into our mixture and give it a little shake before mixing it with our water. We're gonna do 5 tablespoons of vodka. 1 tablespoon of vodka. 2 tablespoons of vodka. 3 tablespoons of vodka. You know what? We're gonna do 3 tablespoons of vodka, even though the recipe calls for 5. I may not have paid attention to the size of their bottle versus the size of my bottle, and that's okay. You know, there's freedom in not paying full attention to the recipes you're using. Or we're just gonna say there's freedom. I don't know if there is.
How much water does it call for?
We may just not use our water. Like, that's fine. It's because this mixture is fully vodka.
That's not good.
Why not?
The water dulls it down. You're spraying vodka.
And essential oils. Vodka and essential oils. So now we're gonna give it a little shake before we mix with our water. If you're gonna try this at home, I might suggest just doing 2 tablespoons of vodka and maybe leaving the almond oil out, because this is what did it. This is what put me over. So I just read a different recipe and she didn't use water at all. She just used vodka. So this is not a crisis. It's all okay. If you got a tiny bottle like I did and there's no room for your water, it's okay. Leave the water out. There's more room for vodka to enjoy itself. I'm just shaking at this point. It said to shake for just like a few seconds. So now I guess I will test it out. One article suggested letting it sit like in a cool dark place for 2 days or up to 2 weeks to let the like oils just sort of combine and you know, the smell is stronger. And I get that, but I'm impatient. So I wanna spray it now. think it smells fantastic. And no one would ever know that it's purely vodka. It's got a really good smell.
I'm excited about mine.
Yes, I'm gonna make it just after I finish this video. Before I end the video, I want to say, if you're going to make a body spray from essential oils, I have to highly suggest that you use high quality essential oils. It's just that the ones that you may find in the cheaper big box stores, they're just not high quality, and a lot of them are actually full of chemicals. So that being said, just do some research on the essential oils that you want to use. I have a lot of friends that use doTERRA, and I know it's a very high quality oil company as well. I've even used some of their oils. However, I am a Young Living fan. I've been using their oils for almost 2 years. I happen to be a distributor. If you would like to message me for more information on Young Living, totally feel free. Like, I love to have conversations about oils. Even if you don't plan on ever buying oils from me and just have oily questions, shoot me a message. Let's chat about oils. It's another one of my passions. If you attempt this project or something super similar, let me know how it goes. Hopefully you had a smoother process than I did, but I really want to know how it goes for you. As for me, right now, this very moment, I'm gonna make Randy's. I will see you guys on the next video.